Hello guys, it's Destiny and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I want to show you guys how to build a simple program that would help us roll to dice and give us some random results with Python. And you would learn some basic things you need to know if you're a beginner in Python. So let's get started. Now in this course, I'll be using PyCharm IDE to write my codes. You could use the Visual Studio Code or the Sublime Text, whatever you want to use. So the next thing you want to do is come over here and right click on new, and I'll create a new Python file, and we're gonna name this let's just say dice row, something like that. So in here, the first thing I want to do is go ahead and import random. So I'm gonna import random, and after importing random, I want to pass in a minimum value. So I can say min is gonna be 1, just like that, and the max is gonna be 6. So in the die, there is a minimum number of 1 and there is a max number of 6. It doesn't go below 1 and it doesn't exceed 6. So that's why I'm using min 1 and max 6. Hopefully you understand. Now the next thing I want to say is, let's just define a variable, and this is gonna be like roll again, and let's just pass in years over here. So later we're gonna implement a very simple method that's gonna help us, or function that's gonna help us, like give us an option to roll the die again, like when we have already gotten a result. So this is what we're gonna use to implement that. So the next thing I want to say is while roll again. So while roll again is still equal to yes, like this, or let's say the user is gonna use y, or roll again is equal to y. So I'll explain what all this does, but let's go ahead and keep writing the codes. So while roll again is equal to yes or equal to y, now what do we want to do? We want to go ahead and print the outcomes of the result. So firstly, I want to say print, and I could just pass in, not in here, not in a string, I could just pass in a random. So you remember we imported random over there at the top. So we'll just say random that random integer, like this, and we're gonna pass in min, and we're also gonna pass in max. So with this, we also need to do the same thing again. So because in the die, it has like two, we are rolling two dice in this case, and there's going to be like two results. One is going to be min, one is going to be max, another one is going to be min, another one is going to be max, and hopefully you understand. So let's go ahead and run this and see if it really works. But without this, now let's go ahead and just do one more thing. So just say, I want to say roll again is equal to impute, and this is going to have a prompt of it's going to have something like do you want to roll again, do you want to roll again, something like that. And let's go ahead and run this and see what we have now. So we right click and run die, and as you can see, it gives us 4 and 1, and it says do you want to roll again. If you say why, you see it gives us another random number. If you say yes, you see it gives us random numbers. So you could go ahead and style this and make things look more better. For example, you could import time. So let's just import time from here, and the next thing I want to do over here is go ahead and say something like let's say print hold on rolling dice now, something like that. And down here we could just say time dot sleep, so time will sleep, and let's say one passing 2 sec in there. And the next one, we could just copy this and let's say paste it down to some places, and let's paste this out a bit and run this. Let's see what we have now. So you see, hold on rolling dice now, it makes it look more cinematic, you know, and you see it's chosen this at us. So we can go ahead and make things look more better. For example, we could just get hold of this and this, and in here we can open up a string just like this, and we can concatenate this, and in here we'll say first die, and this is gonna be second die. So I could just go ahead and copy this that's in here, sorry I cut it, so just copy this and I'm gonna paste them in here, and hopefully everything's gonna look good. So finally I'm gonna change this to second die, and I think we might get an error that says cannot concatenate integer or something like that. But firstly, let's go ahead and run this. So we run this now, it says hold on rolling dice, and finally hold on rolling dice, and As you can see, it throws an error, and anyway, we're gonna get this error. So it says can only concatenate string, not integer. So all we have to do is just get hold of this. So I'm just go ahead and cut this and open up a string like that, str. Then I'm gonna paste this in there. Then I can just copy this one if you want, or you could just do it manually. So just copy this and paste it in here, and everything should be working fine now. Let's see if everything is looking good. So with this now, let's go ahead and run and see what we have. So we run this, it says hold on rolling dice. Then finally it says first die 6, second die 3. And as you can see, if you say roll again, it will go ahead and roll the dice. But I think this times they are just like so slow, we just leave it at 1 sec. So now we will rerun this and say hold on rolling dice, and as you can see, it's true stats at us. So that's pretty much it for this video, and hopefully you understood the logic that went into building this. But if you don't, let me just go ahead and explain this one more time. So over here we imported random and time, and this random is going to help us randomly pick a password. You remember we randomly pick passwords. Let me go ahead and run this again so you see. So I'm running this now, and as you can see, we have random values over here. We have 5, we have 6 as first and second die. So that's what this random is going to do for us. And time, what time is going to do is, you remember it says something like hold on rolling die and hold on rolling die. Like after it say this one, it say this one, and it took like 1 second. So that's what we're using time to do. Minimum value of first die is going to be 1. Minimum value of second die is going to be 6. Sorry, the max value of second die is going to be 6. In a normal die, there is a maximum and minimum number. The minimum number is 1, the maximum number is 6. So right here, what we just say is define a variable, roll again, and we'll pass it to yes. Now in here we say while roll again is equal to yes. So if roll again is equal to yes, but this is not an if statement, we are using while, because we want like a while loop, something like that, like a loop. But you can still go ahead and use if statement if you want. Yeah, let's see if we use if and run this now. Let's see, run. As you can see, hold on rolling dice, and as you can see, it still does exactly the same thing, but now it's not in a while loop. So when you press Y or yes, it's not gonna roll the die again. So that's why I'm using while loop. But you can go ahead and use if whatever. So it says if roll again is still equal to yes, or let's say what the user want to choose is Y. So that's why I use this one. It doesn't really mean you could totally get rid of this one and everything is still gonna work fine. So while roll again is still equal to yes, I want to just print hold on rolling dice. So this is just to make things look more better. All this code over here doesn't necessarily mean you can go ahead and get rid of them. This is only where the logic comes to play. So firstly, I say it print random dot random integer. So I called the random function that we imported over here, and I called random integer, then passed in min and max. So I wanted to choose between minimum and this and choose a particular number. And for the second die, I also did the same thing. So it's randomly gonna choose from 1 to 6 and from 6 to 1 and choose it to us. So over here, why it was very easy, I just defined the variable row again, which is this one we have over here, and we'll set it to an input that will allow the user pass in their own command or something like that. So let's go ahead and run this for the very last time. So we go ahead, we run this, says hold on rolling dice, and as you can see, it says first die 4, second die 1. So that's pretty much it for this video. Hopefully you understood the logic that went into building this video, and if you did, don't forget to drop a like on this video, consider subscribing, as it will mean the world to me, and I hope I'll see you in my next video. I love, peace out.